root cause of moral and spiritual degeneration. We at Indian Vegetarian Congress, we are working for important task, since it will lead to a more humane world at peace with animal kingdom and with each other. We at IVC define a vegetarian as one who does not at any time or under any circumstances eat meat, fish, fowl, eggs, or any other type of flesh food. Vegetarian does not come from vegetable. Now, this is very important, friends, understand. The word vegetarian does not come from vegetable. The root is derived from the word vegetus, V-E-G-E-T-U-S, meaning whole, sound, fresh, lively. Nothing is more powerful than an individual acting out of his conscience, thus helping to bring the collective conscience to life. That is what Norman Cousin said. And what does Albert Schweitzer has to say? Until man extends his circle of compassion to all living things, man will not find peace for himself. It is a man's sympathy with all creatures that first makes him truly a human being. Now, friends, I will go next to the most important topic, and that is the medical viewpoint. It's a fallacy, friend. It's a myth to say that we don't get enough protein from veg food. And that is why a man must have flesh food that is rich in protein. I'll come one by one to these myths. First of all, I will first give you examples of those strong animals, say elephant, say rhino. These are the strongest animals on this earth. Are they meat eaters? No. They are pure veg. Even if they die, they will not eat meat. Even then, they are the strongest. Take example of horse. We talk about horse power. It's the most powerful creature useful for our purpose, and that is also a pure vegetarian. And take examples of cattle, cows, bullock, and other animals. They are not only useful to us, but they are pure vegetarian. My point here is that those vegetarian animals are strong enough and they don't need any flesh food. In fact, if stupidly flesh food is given to these veg animals, what will happen? You all know about the mad cow disease, the syndrome called BEC. Friends, this BSE, bovine spongiform encephalopathy, you know what happened a few years back in England? It was a result of feeding rendered sheep byproducts to cattle as protein supplement. These sheep were infected with scrapie, an SE disease known for over 200 years. Now, if sheep food can make a cow mad, what do you expect the result on human being? Millions of innocent cows were killed mercilessly just because they were suspected to be infected with BSE, and that too for no fault of theirs, but the stupid ways of feeding sheep protein on absolutely unnatural diet for a cow. So is the case with humans. Animal protein is not natural for us. Similarly, millions of chicks were destroyed in Eastern Asia countries because they were infected with certain disease. Now, coming back to healthy diet, I will quote from one Dr. Dean Ornish, who has written a very learned book on how to reverse heart disease without surgery or drugs. And this book, my friends, is the bestseller in America now. It has really created interest in the people of America and all over the world, for that matter, that veg food is definitely better from medical point of view. He has given two types of diet, one reversal and one prevention of heart disease. Both are strictly veg diets, because he has proved scientifically that veg food is the best food for a human being. It not only helps heart patients, but also reduces risk of other degenerating and fatal diseases caused by flesh food, diseases like cancers of colon, cancers of breast, cancers of prostate, obesity, high blood pressure, stroke, diabetes, gallstones. The Surgeon General of America has confirmed this in the report on nutrition and health. He has given certain facts for protein. Friends, we'll have to be a little technical about it. The protein is formed from building blocks called amino acids. These are of million varieties, of which only three are critical for us: lysine, tryptophan, and methionine. All these are available in animals as well as veg, plant food. But when one consumes animal food for getting these three critical amino acids, one also consumes unnecessary elements like cholesterol, saturated fat. Friends, these are the two things that are the prime reason, the killers for human being: cholesterol and saturated fat. Now let us address the issue that is universally put forward, that we do not get sufficient protein from vegetarian food. And so we have to turn to flesh food for adequate supply of amino acids. Now this is a fallacy. A combined meal of legumes and cereals. Legumes means dal, pulses, and cereals mean wheat, rice, etc. You have to combine these two and you get a complete balanced diet which provides complete protein, which is not different from protein found in eggs or meat, but without cholesterol and animal instincts. One dietetic association has stated positive relationship between vegetable lifestyles and risk reduction for several chronic degenerative diseases, as mentioned earlier. It has confirmed that veg diet is healthier and more nutritious. Plant food is totally free from cholesterol, which is found in both. But cholesterol is only found in animal products such as meat, poultry, fish, and dairy. Flesh food is also high in saturated fats, which our liver converts into cholesterol. Our body makes all the cholesterol we need. Now, this is very important, friends. You must understand. We need cholesterol, but we don't have to take cholesterol from animal food. Our body, it's a wonderful mechanism. The biochemistry, the chemical factory of our body, can manufacture all proteins, all cholesterol from our own system. 3/4 of the cholesterol in our blood is made by our body. It is the excessive amounts of cholesterol and saturated fat in the diet that lead to coronary heart disease. The other diseases, friends, which I have summarized from various journals, medical journals: epilepsy, infected flesh, kidney diseases, excessive protein, excessive uric acid. These are all the diseases because of the flesh food. Rheumatoid, arthritis, gout. This is the direct consequence of uric acid found in flesh food. Degeneration of intestines, decay in immunity system. Dr. Deepak Chopra of America has stated that our body is capable of living for more than 100 years if we take proper care of it. Now look at the population in extreme north region, Eskimos. Now perforce, because no vegetation is available, they have to take flesh food. And the average life of an Eskimo is only 30 years. All non-veg